Welcome back, everyone. My next guest is not only my guest, but she's also my sponsor. I have with me Anna von Straussenburg, and she's the owner of L. Anna von Straussenburg, CPA. Welcome back. You just had a beautiful ribbon cutting. I was just there to see it. Tell everybody a little bit about yourself, what you're doing, and about the ribbon cutting. I want you to talk a little bit. It was fabulous. And welcome back to the show.
Well, thank you. I'm glad to be back, and the ribbon cutting was fabulous. And it was kind of funny because I really started my business about 3 years ago, but then soon after it started, COVID happened, so we never did the ribbon cutting. And so I decided to do one now because I have a whole new staff and everything's finally settled. I got all the pictures on the walls, and so it was just the right time. And we actually have one day where everybody's going to be together because one of my employees is kind of a snowbird, and she's working remotely from North Dakota.
Wow.
And I love her dearly. She's new to me, but she is just a hoot because she always has these fun sayings from up north.
Well, let's talk about sayings right now. I have to say something. Excellence and integrity in accounting. You are all about that. And I want you to listen up, everyone, because, you know, I have now known you for a few years now. And there's one thing about Anna that, you know, she can't tell a lie in for the life of her, yeah, right? But you are all about service and doing the right thing. Just when somebody, you were just talking about somebody, doesn't matter what it was, they were talking to you on the phone, and they said something really quick as they were hanging up, and she says, oh my God, no, I need to call her back right away and let her know exactly so she understands. And this is what I love about you and the way that you work with your client. That's not just the way you work, it is the way you are as a human being.
Yes, I pride myself in having strong ethics, and then I also pride myself on doing the best job I can possibly do. I stand by my work. If I ever make a mistake, I stand by that. And if somebody gets a penalty that caused by me, I will pay that penalty. And it motivates me to do the best job I can do. But, you know, we're human. Mistakes happen.
Mm-hmm.
But I try to keep them. I keep them as small, as few and far between as possible.
So you were also nominated for the Torch Award for integrity. Was it integrity?
Yeah, for the, it's called the Better Business Bureau Torch Award for Ethics.
Ethics.
And so, yes, I was proud to be nominated. Unfortunately, I didn't make the finals this year, but maybe next year.
Well, I've
hopefully
already
I'll keep getting nominated.
I've been stuff in the ballot box, you know, ever since I left the last one. But you're going to win for sure. I know.
I hope so.
You know, and that's not an easy thing to get, folks. It's not even easy to be nominated. Forget, you know, just winning is obviously huge. But these are things that when you hear this about the people that you work with, like Anna, it's something that you need to understand that these are prestigious awards that they get, and they work hard for it. Now, when you work with people, okay, let's talk about first how you work hand in hand with them and how you almost are like a teacher teaching them. It's not just about, you know, people think taxes are you bring your stuff in, they do it, it's done. Thank you for making me look good or bad or whatever you need to do so that you do the best job you can for them. And then what do you do to hold their hands?
Well, for my individual clients, I try to educate them on the tax law and talk to them about, you know, do you need to make estimated tax payments? Do you need to change your withholding? Because a lot of people just aren't aware of what they need to do. For my business clients, I kind of have a very specific program that I like to get my clients onto where I do their books, look at their books 3 times a year. The first time is usually in July, and we kind of take a, you know, 6 month look at the client's business and see where it's kind of trending. And then my really big time is in November. I look at the books all the way through the end of October, and usually by the time I get the material and look at it, November's mostly over, so I can get good numbers for November. And most businesses kind of have an idea where they're going to go the last month of the year. And so we try to project what the taxpayer's liability is going to be and how the business is going to look at the end of the year so that we can discuss doing some tax planning. Do you want to make a payment to your retirement plan? Do you need to buy more assets? Are you running a little low? Maybe you should try to accelerate some collections from clients, or do you need to accelerate payments to your vendors? You know, whatever it is to make your business work better and take advantage of any tax opportunities. And of course, then we look at the books finally when we really do the tax return.
Right, absolutely. What I love about Anna is that she's all about you learning your numbers, knowing ahead of time of where you're going to stand. And obviously, that is what it's all about. What do I need to owe? And you help them as well in that area, trying to get as many legal deductions as possible. I know I'm going to say this, you just did my daughter's recently, right?
Yes.
And it was so nice that she really, I mean, talk about not knowing what, she's a blonder, okay? So, I mean, really, she had no idea what she could do, and you helped her, and you thought of things for her. Well, did you think of this? Oh, and you know what? It was so nice for her because obviously she didn't end up owing what she thought she might have to.
Yeah.
And she tried to do it on her own, and what did I say to her? Don't do it on your own. I said, call Anna.
Yep, that's right. And that kind of leads into some of the things I want to talk about today.
Which I was going to talk about that now, which is business misconceptions.
Okay, well, when you start off a business, a lot of people become an LLC, which is a great thing. But a lot of people don't understand what the LLC means. The LLC is basically a state registration. It does not dictate what kind of tax return you do. What dictates what kind of tax return you do is how you've set up your entity. Do you have partners? Well, if you have partners, your LLC must report as a partnership. If you're a single owner, well, then you have some choices. You can be an S corp, you can be a C corp, which nobody wants to be pretty much, or you can be like a sole proprietorship. And the S corp is a legal designation as opposed to a tax designation. So, and there's the thing about people liking to do it themselves. When I tell people about electing their business and setting up the LLC, I always advise them, seek out a paralegal or an attorney. You know, if you're doing a partnership with a different person that you're not related to, you very well want to have some good agreements written up, you know, in addition to the LLC election. And so I always encourage people to get professionals as part of their team. You know, hey, I am not a plumber. And
me neither.
After trying to do it myself a couple times, I now hire somebody.
Absolutely.
And the same thing too. If you're on the other foot, if you're a plumber and you need help with legal matters or accounting, don't go the route do it yourself. There's those things out there, TurboTax and LegalZoom, and you can do it yourself, but it's not a good idea.
And how many times when you do people's books, how many times do you find them money that they didn't have to pay when they did it on their own and they made big mistakes?
Certainly. When I have reviewed people's tax returns that they've done on the, you know, on the TurboTax or that kind of program, I have every single time found errors, and always in the client's favor.
It's always in it. Absolutely. Yeah. This is why you need to listen up to the things that you hear here on the show and put this number in your phone. Her phone number is 480-964-4030. That's 480-964-4030. Her website is ArizonaCPAsWithAnS.com. She's rated with the Better Business Bureau. She works nationwide. She does free consultations. To me, it is absolutely worth it. Thank you for all that you do. We're going to go to a break. We're going to come back. We're going to talk further. Hang tight, and we'll be back in just a minute.
hear that all the time from business owners and leaders that just aren't getting the same results from their hard work they used to. I'm Ken Kilday, and I work with business owners and leaders to unlock their leadership genius. Start today with a breakthrough strategy session and start making the cut. Call or text 602-820-6978 or online at makingthecut.biz. That's 602-820-6978 or online at makingthecut.biz.
People from all over want to come to Arizona, so why not turn property you already own into a vacation home? At iTrip Vacations, we're invested in your success. Our boutique customer service ensures your questions are answered, your peace of mind is intact, and your property is expertly maintained. Plus, we partner with dozens of rental services to maximize marketing and keep your property booked. Call 480-586-9096 today or visit itriptempe.com.
Pass Fire Protection Systems is your Arizona statewide fire safety systems expert. With over 35 years experience, our service includes installation, maintenance, repair, and training. We specialize in commercial kitchens, paint suppression systems, fire alarm systems, fire sprinkler systems, fire extinguishers, and food truck installations and service. Whether you're looking to upgrade your current system or need fire safety inspections to remain compliant, Pass Fire Protection Systems are the team to call. Contact us at 602-833-9117 or visit us at passfireprotection.com.
KFNX Cave Creek.
Do you have a parent, grandparent, or loved one who needs some extra help? Senior Helpers has spent 16 years helping seniors continue to live at home as they age. Do you have a loved one needing help with grocery shopping, meal preparation, or even help taking a shower? Call Senior Helpers today at 480-621-6672. We specialize in helping seniors with Alzheimer's and dementia, Parkinson's disease, and other chronic illnesses to stay at home. You can find us online at seniorhelpers.com or at 480-621-6672.
What if I told you that getting Medicare coverage doesn't have to be a complicated process? Are you tired of being confused with the many coverage options available to you with Medicare? At Tapestry Insurance Group, let us help by taking the confusion and complication out of your Medicare options so you can get the coverage you need. Some available plans have no additional premium and may help lower your out-of-pocket costs. There's never a cost for a consultation with one of our licensed agents, so don't delay. Contact us at 602-541-7656 or visit tapestryinsurancegroup.com.
Frequent trips to the bathroom keeping you up at night? Sudden urges or leaking when you cough or sneeze, interfering with your quality of life? Then VJuve Med Spa is your answer. All treatments are non-invasive without drugs or surgery and FDA approved. Approved by Medicare too. Our treatment is also incredibly affordable and convenient. With 4 locations in Mesa Surprise and Scottsdale. Schedule your free consultation at stopthep.com or call 480-593-5400 for the relief you've been looking for. Let VJuve make you a better you. If I traded
it all. Welcome back, everyone. We're talking with Anna von Straussenburg. She is the owner of L. Anna von Straussenburg CPA. And we're talking a little bit, of course, to Facebook Land during the break. That's what we do. And I was talking about some of the different things people do. And we talked about procrastination.
Well, you know, a lot of people procrastinated and they filed extensions for their tax return. And, well, a lot of people don't understand what the extension means. The extension is a time to file your tax return. It's not an extension of a time to pay. So you do, filing is an extension, you do avoid one penalty. You avoid the late filing penalty, but there are other penalties called late payment penalties, and there's interest. And so it's important if you have procrastinated, get in touch with your CPA and get your tax return done now, because you'll reduce your penalties by getting it done sooner than later.
That phone number to call, it's 480-964-4030. 480-964-4030. Check her out on her website. It's arizonacpas.com. So you also said that procrastination and not paying kind of go hand in hand.
They do. And it's so important to try to, you know, get an estimate of where you're going to be before April 15th so that you can at least, you know, if you can't pay it all, pay in what you can. The more you pay towards it before April 15th, the better off you're going to be.
Well, there's a lot of people, though, that don't pay at all because they've been putting their heads in the sand, not just for 1 year, sometimes more.
And what we can do there is help you get an installment agreement. And that's very important because then the IRS knows that you're going to pay, And, you know, it can, if you're one-time person, you know, one-time thing, sometimes once you've paid all your taxes, if this was a one-shot deal, then you may be lucky and the IRS may waive some of the penalties.
No, they're brutal.
They're brutal.
They really are brutal.
Well, you know, it's somebody like
when they
me,
want their money, they come and get it.
That's why you want somebody like me to talk to the IRS, because I just know how to sweet talk them sometimes, and I've gotten them to reduce penalties.
You have talked about this before,
yeah.
And it's so important for people to hear this, because, you know, a lot of times people try and do things on their own. Again, we've said this over and over again, do not do this on your own. And there's a good reason here. First of all, the person that's on the other line that you're talking to, they know how to get you to trip you up, number one. Mm-hmm. Number two, you're emotionally involved in it,
yeah.
Right? And then you start talking nasty, and when you do,
oh no, that's you want to be nice to them and goodbye, and they won't help you if you know they're human beings on the other end of the phone. And so I've just developed a way of establishing a rapport with those agents and getting them on the side of my client, and so that I can say, well, this person really is trying, but they may have made a lot of money last year, but now they've had a hiccup and they're in debt and they really need some help.
Yeah.
And so I get them on the side of my client and get those penalties reduced. Interest, no, they cannot waive interest, but they can waive penalties.
Well, that's fine. If they waive something, I'm happy, right? You know?
Right, right.
But you need to make sure that you do your taxes. And I'm going to talk about this for a second. I'm going to just go right into what we've been talking about all day today.
Uh-huh.
From even starting a business and having somebody with a business plan that helps you do things like that. But also, I remember when I first started my business, oh my gosh, I was like just divorced, and I didn't have, my taxes were, nothing was done, right? And so once I did that, I felt so professional, number one. I felt good. It was like this lift off of me that I felt really like, wow, I'm really together. And it took me off on a way into a better direction as I just knew what I was doing.
Yeah, and that's important to know what you're doing and to build a good team of people around you that can help support your business. And gee, I've got two people sitting right here in the room. I've got Carol and I've got Ken, and they're part of my team. And it's so important to hire a group of professionals, including your CPA, to be a part of your team. You know, they're not your employees, but they're still part of your team that you pay for them as outside contractors that can help you build your business. I help you learn your numbers. And learning your numbers helps you to make valid decisions. You know, some people aren't making very much money, yet they go off and buy a whole bunch of equipment that they may or may not need. And so I can sit down with a person and evaluate, well, you know, you're getting all gung-ho on buying all this equipment because you can get a tax write-off, but do you realize you're not making a whole lot of money? And if you can put that off till next year, you might be better off.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm all about doing some proactive tax planning. And that's what you want. When you start a business, you want to be able to plan out your strategy.
Absolutely. There's nothing like having somebody that's going to hold your hand like that. If you've got a CPA where you don't talk to them for like once a year, you know, that's not what you're looking for. You want somebody that's there helping you understand your numbers. It's what it's all about. And making sure that you don't have those penalties that you can get if you procrastinate or if you get those extensions and you don't understand. She's on top of it already with you. So that's what makes her great. Again, that phone number to call her, it's 480-964-4030. That's 480-964-4030. Arizona CPAs with an S.com. You know, what would be some of the things that I want to make sure you get everything out that you want to talk about before I ask you another question? Go ahead.
Well, I want to say that one of the things I do is I get to know my client and their business, because one of the things one of my mentors taught me back then is know your client's business. Know what they do, because then when you understand what their business is, then you can help them more. And it's interesting because I've gotten to learn about all kinds of businesses. I've learned about nonprofits. I've learned about manufacturing businesses. And I've actually got, you know, had the client give me a tour of their manufacturing facility and go in and
that's
see
so
how
cool.
they put together the little widgets.
I love that.
And that's, you know, was helpful for me. And I actually, one client, you know, I'm a QuickBooks Pro advisor, and we actually set up a way to track their inventory because they were building their inventory from scratch, you know, building their parts that they sold with wires and connectors, and because they manufactured the hangers for the ceilings you see in office buildings.
See, we're about
and,
now and Arizona,
it was
would
such
you learn
a
that?
Wonderful learning experience
That's
for
neat.
Me and how to set it up in QuickBooks. And we worked together as a team to get it set up.
You also like complicated returns.
Oh, I love complicated. That's my wheelhouse. If somebody has multi-states or, you know, like I said, the business returns like that, or, you know, if somebody has a high net worth return, those have their special needs. And a lot of times those people also have to do gift tax returns. And so there's so many aspects of the tax world. And, you know, if you have something complicated, that's
she's the gal to call.
I'm the person for you because that is my wheelhouse.
Absolutely. And even though when you think about a complicated tax return, I thought that my daughter's was kind of complicated because being if somebody owns your own business, but because of the kind of work that she does, there was a lot more deductions that she would never would have thought about because it was a little bit complicated.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe about a bit as complicated as some of the others that you do.
Yeah.
But, you know, I was grateful that you did do that because it seemed like it might be a little complicated.
Yeah, it wasn't that complicated for me, but I realized that when she gave me her deductions that, you know, one of the deductions clued me in that, like, well, you had to travel for business, but you didn't give me any meals. Didn't you have to eat while you traveled? And those things, when it's a business purpose, you can deduct it. And so I asked her about some of her expenses for traveling, and then all of a sudden all sorts of expenses came up.
Yeah, and that's how you get to know your client.
Yeah.
That's what's really neat about it.
And I talked to them, and, you know, I've watched some of my clients' kids grow up, and it's delightful.
I'm sure.
Yeah. I saw one guy in the grocery store the other day, and he reached out and gave me a great big hug.
There's nothing like hugging your CPA, because when you have a CPA with a sharp pencil and knows what they're doing, you love them, right? You talk to them more than one time a year, too. So I want to ask, I was going to say something, and I can't remember what it was, it went right over my head as to end the show. But, you know, obviously complicated is really big. But excellence and integrity in accounting, this is what is the first and foremost what you stand by at all times.
I do. And one other thing I'd like to emphasize, I am a QuickBooks Pro advisor. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I really learned a lot in the desktop way back when, and now everything's changed over to the online version. And I have to admit, I was not the biggest fan of the online version, but I've, out of necessity, I've had to learn it. So, you know, I love a good challenge, and I guess that is one of my challenges.
But you teach that to your
yes.
clients.
Yes.
This is what I want you to hear, too, about her, because being a QuickBooks advisor like she is, and you've been doing that for a very long time, she can help you start that up, which a lot of people, you know, and don't like that. They're still like me, like kind of pen and pencil kind of gal. But, you know, it's great when you do it like that with you because it's just so much easier. And it's when it's easier, it's better for you, correct?
That's true. You know, it's all about being organized. And if there are more of my clients are organized, the less their bill is.
Their phone number, it's 480-964-4030. It is ArizonaCPAs.com. Across